Hello students, in this presentation we will discuss about the education in Vedic age. Now when we start exploring the history of education, we realize that education has its roots in the Vedic age. The Vedic period or Vedic age is the period in the late Bronze Age and early Iron Age of the history of India when the Vedas were composed in the northern Indian subcontinent. Between the end of the urban Indus Valley civilization and a second urbanization which began in the central Indo-Gangetic plain.
Dear students, the ancient system of education which was based on the Vedas was called as Vedic educational system. Vedas are the oldest text available in the world and they are written by the Indian rishis, also called Brahmins or Acharyas, who were responsible for the spread of education in the society at that time. Thus, Indian educational system is believed to be the oldest system in the world. This period of Vedas has been subdivided by some scholars into periods like Rig Veda period, Brahmani period, Upanishad period, Samriti period or Sutra period. But because the aims and the ideals of education in these sub-periods were same as the Vedas, we always refer to the education in this period as Vedic education. Swadesh Pujyate Raja Vidwan Sarvatra Pujyate. This quote has been widely quoted in Indian education system and it tells about the importance of education in Indian society.
Let us now discuss the aim of education in the Vedic period. The literature and culture of ancient India was mostly the means of preaching religion. Learning was largely pursued for the sake of religion. It was sought as the means of salvation or self-realization, also called mukti or emancipation. The ultimate aim of human society was the achievement of the absolute, that is Brahma. It was believed that souls forget the absolute due to ignorance and illiteracy. The Upanishads teach the way of salvation and oneness with the Absolute by the destruction of this ignorance and illiteracy. What was the form of education during the Vedic period? Vedic literature includes the Vedic Samhita, Brahmans and Aranyakas, also called Upanishads. But while considering the Vedic education, it is proper to think over the Vedas only. The literal meaning of Vedas is the knowledge and the word is derived from the word vid, that is root, meaning to know. Thus Veda means the knowledge of various types. Vedic education revolves around the four Vedas, which are the Rig Veda, the Yajur Veda, the Sam Veda and the Atharva Veda. The four Vedas were compiled in the Mahabharata age by Rishi Vedavyasa. He compiled these four samhitas, which are the collection of various mantras. Let us now see what is contained in these four Vedas. The first Veda or the Rig Veda is the oldest extant Indic text. It is a collection of 1028 Vedic Sanskrit hymns and 10,600 verses in all, organized into 10 books, Sanskrit mandalas. The hymns are dedicated to Rig Vedic deities. The Yajurveda Samhita consists of prose mantras. It is a compilation of ritual offering formulas that were said by a priest while an individual performed ritual actions, such as those before the Yajna fire. There are two major groups of texts in this Veda, the black Krishna and the white Shukla. The term black implies the unarranged, motley collection of verses in Yajurveda, in contrast to the white, which are very well arranged. The Samveda Samhita has two parts, Archika and Uttra Archika, having 1875 hymns. Many of them are from Rig Veda. Samveda has only 75 hymns of its own, which can be sung. The fourth Veda is the Atharvaveda. It is the text belonging to the Atharvan and Angirasa poets. It has about 760 hymns, and about 160 of the hymns are in common with the Rig Veda. Most of the verses are metrical, but some sections are in prose. Two different versions of the text, the Pipalada and the Sonakya, have survived into the modern times. Let us now discuss the salient features of Vedic education. The first feature of Vedic education was the existence of Gurukuls. Gurukuls were the centers of education. Initially, rishis, also called acharyas, used to teach the religious hymns to their sons and grandsons. Gradually, as they developed their methods of teaching, children from outside their families were also taken as disciples. The house of the guru was called the Gurukul, where the disciples stayed till the completion of their education. Next, we talk about the ideal of the guru and the relation between guru and the shishyas. The gurus were men of high caliber and possessed vast knowledge of Vedas and Vedic rituals. They enjoyed high repute in the society. They treated their disciples as their sons, who in turn served their gurus as their fathers. The students stayed in the Gurukuls and did all the necessary jobs of the Gurukul, like cooking, cleanliness, grazing cows, and begging alms from the people to inculcate humbleness in the disciples. Another feature was that there was no state control on education. The rulers of the time did not interfere in the educational matters. The education was left to the rishis, who took the responsibility of preaching the knowledge of Vedas in true spirit and taking care of the spiritual, moral, and religious development of their disciples. Another feature was about the Brahmin Sangs. It was an organization where meritorious students were given chance to fulfill their quest of higher knowledge. These sangs may be compared to the seminars of the modern times, as they had all the qualities of these seminars. What were the courses of study and literature? The students were required to learn the four Vedas by heart, and they also studied Shiksha, Kalpa, Vyakrana, Jyotish, Chanda, Nirukta, and logic in general. They specialized in one of these subjects. The methods of instruction. The Vedic system of education was psychological. Two forms of education were in vogue. Verbal, that is the self-study, and second was meditation. The disciples followed three methods to learn the hymns properly. The first was Sarvana, that is, they listened to their teacher or guru. Then they did Manana, that is, they repeated the hymns after the teacher. The third one was Nididhyasana or meditation. Questioning and discussions were a part of the teaching. Another feature we talk about is the medium of instructions. During the Vedic education, Sanskrit was the basic medium of instructions. What was the status of women education in the time of Vedas? Girls were educated in the same way as the boys, and many of them gained highest education and were called Brahmavadini and attained the status of Rishika. Some of the women were regarded as devis and they even composed hymns. The Vedic education was not dominated by males only. The females, also called Rishikas, also educated the people. and they attained a high stature in the Vedic period. There are over 36 Rishikas who are mentioned in Vedic texts, and the names are like Aditi, Agnya, Bharati, Chandra, Devakama, Devi, Dhruva, Havya, Ida, Jyota, Kamya, Shama, Mahi, Meena, Nari, Purandhi, Ranta, Ratavari, Sanjaya, Saraswati, Simhi, Shivi, Shivatma, Stri, Subhaga, Subhada, Sumangali, Susheva, Suvarcha, Suyama, Suyona, Virini, Vishruta, Yashvati and Yoshi. The education of the other castes. The education was free to everyone and all the castes had a right to get educated, though the subjects taught varied according to the needs of various castes. Then another feature was about art and craft education. Though religious education was given priority, but subjects of vocational value like agriculture, animal husbandry, military education, that is making weapons, were also taught during the Vedic period.
So students, we can come to the conclusion of Vedic educational system by saying that Vedas were the first formal books which the students read, and Vedic education was the first formal education in the world. This education was very lofty and comprehensive, and its ultimate aim was self-realization, which was achieved by fulfilling the worldly duties. Another very interesting feature which we come across is that Vedas never preached any discrimination based on caste and gender. And any such discrimination which later came up in the Indian education system was brought about by the society. Thank you so much.
A mediocre teacher explains, a good teacher demonstrates, and a great teacher inspires. A journey which began over 100 years ago, this is the story of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Khalsa College, also known as the Wonder in Rural Hinterland.
ਨੈਲ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਅਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਦਾ ਜੰਮਪਲ ਹਾਂ ਔਰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਸਕੂਲਿੰਗ ਹੈ ਮੇਰੀ ਮੈਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਗਰਾਊਂਡਾਂ 'ਚ ਖੇਡਿਆ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੜ੍ਹਿਆ ਹੈਗਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਰਿਪੇਅਰ ਜਦੋਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਸੀ ਛੱਤਾਂ ਵਗੈਰਾ ਦੀ ਅਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਥਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕ੍ਰੈਸ਼ਰ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਸੀਮੈਂਟ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਇੱਟਾਂ ਫੜਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਯੂ ਕਾਂਟ ਥਿੰਕ ਆਫ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੱਕ ਆ ਗਏ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ ਰਹੇ ਇਸ ਕਾਲਜ ਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਮੇਰੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਜੀ ਕਲਾਸ ਫੈਲੋ ਸੀਗੇ ਔਰ ਫਸਟ ਬੈਚ ਦੇ ਇਹ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟ ਸੀਗੇ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਫਰੀ ਆਫ ਕੋਸਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਕਈ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਰਹੇ ਔਰ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖਾਣਾ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫਰੀ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਸੀ ਹੋਸਟਲ ਫੈਸਿਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੀਗੀਆਂ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀਗਾ ਸਾਡੇ ਦੇਖਣ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਔਰ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੰਨੀ ਸੋਚ ਸਾਡੀ ਮੈਨੇਜਮੈਂਟ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਮਈ ਜੂਨ ਦੇ ਮਹੀਨਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਧੁੱਪੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਕਿੱਕਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਛਾਂ ਥੱਲੇ ਅਤੇ ਔਰ ਨਾਲ ਦੀ ਨਾਲ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਬੜੀ ਦੇਣ ਆ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਾਲਜ ਹੈਗਾ ਇਹ ਰੂਰਲ ਨਾ ਸਮਝੋ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਇਟਸ ਮੋਰ ਦੈਨ ਏ ਯੂਨੀਵਰਸਿਟੀ ਯੂ ਨੋ